Yeah. Hayson asks, go on, fuel the parasocial frenzy. What were your biggest young adult literature obsessions? We've all heard about Abby and Cherub.
Ooh.
Were any of you Twihards, John Greenstands?
Twihards?
You no. Are a Songlands no, and no. Fire type.
Okay, so I read the Harry Potter books. They didn't mean that much to me. Mm. What I did get really into for a while was, and I think I mentioned this in the episode, the Alex Rider books.
Yeah. I also read all of those.
I read a few of those.
Yeah, read, I think, almost all of those. Artemis Fowl, another big one.
Shit, I think I read the Artemis Fowl ones as well.
It's normal to be named after a girl if you're smart enough. and fucking younger than this. So, like, this was, kind of like way younger, like preteen. But there was one book that, like, still sticks in my head. It's called fucking Harry and the Ring.
I love that book. I read it till it fell apart when I was a little kid. I love that.
Genuinely same. I really love the cover art. It's about a kid who gets sent to stay with his two aunts who are like con artists and criminals.
Yeah.
It's really genuinely very fun. So that's an abiding sort of like YA thing for me. Also Discworld.
Discworld's which right up there.
Never got into Discworld. Mm-hmm. Never read it.
Really? Nope. I think you'd a lot of people really have said enjoy this to it.
Me, yeah, I think you'd have a good time with it.
I read the first Cherub book. I didn't read the series. I read a little bit of Alex Rider, but my big thing was the Aragorn series. I was big into that as a mid-teenager. I think part of what got me into it was I like the kind of dragons and the fantasy stuff, but also Christopher Paolini, the guy who wrote it, he wrote the first one when he was 17, and I was like, oh yeah, like I could be a writer too. Like, and I am now a writer.
Award-winning playwright.
Thank you. That was something that like really got me going. It was like, oh, like he started when he was just a little bit older than me, and like I could write something good like this too. But I really, really enjoyed that series. The evil dragon in the second one, who is forced to be evil and forced to be very macho and violent against his will, is called Thorn. Make of that what you will. I really enjoyed that series. I thought the ending was like, basically I kind of aged out of it by the time the ending book came out. But I did read all of them and I did enjoy it. And then as an adult now, I go back and I look at it, I'm like, oh yeah, this is kind of just like Star Wars, but with elves and dragons. It's kind of if you took Star Wars and Lord of the Rings and smashed them into each other. But I did really enjoy it. And like, I would, if Christopher Paolini, if you're out there, come on the show. Like, and also thank you for writing those books. I really enjoyed them as a teen.
I have a couple of others. I was really into Caroline Lawrence's Roman Mysteries series about like the fucking like mystery solving Roman children. There's another one that I forget. She actually signed a bunch of books for me. So, I know.
I really enjoyed a Michael Morpurgo book called Kensuke's Kingdom.
Oh yeah.
Which was about a kid who got stuck on an island with a Japanese war veteran. That was cool. And also, was it also Michael Morpurgo who wrote Rag Boy?
I think so.
Might have been. But I really enjoyed Rag Boy. It was about a kid in the late 1800s who finds a mermaid washed up on the beach. So it's about a young boy child who suddenly discovers a powerful source of femininity that he has to keep secret away from all the people who will take it away from him. And I was like, this means a lot to me for reasons that I cannot explain.
For reasons I cannot explain, will anyone be surprised that specifically within Discworld, it was the guards' novels that were really formed?
Nah, but they fucking rule, though, is the thing. Feet of Clay is easily one of my favourite of the Discworld series.
The thing is, right, if you don't really fit in society, the answer is to join the police.
I had some weird bloody choices as a child. Just absolutely ripped through Discworld. Absolutely fucking love Discworld. Really, really enjoyed Moving Pictures as maybe my favorite Discworld book. But all of the death ones, like Reaper Man, is fucking phenomenal. Soul Music, I adore. Feet of Clay, as mentioned. Also, Monstrous Regiment is also extremely good.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a niche choice, but it's fantastic. Of just like a bunch of people all at war, each one of them discovering that all of them are women who have lied about being men to join the army. Like, every single person is doing this.
I think my favorite Discworld might actually be Jingo. Which is no one's favorite.
That's a fucking choice. You're not wrong. Thief of Time is also right up there. Fuck, I should just reread the Discworld series, actually. I probably didn't get as much out of it as a child as I would now. Also, I read the Song of Ice and Fire series and had a great time with that. And I read a lot of... The school library had a strange selection of books, but what it did have is a lot of the, like, Star Wars novels with, like, extended universe that was canon before Disney got to it. So, like, the Yuuzhan Vong War and everything like that.
You're, like, fully, like, little dev is in the school library, like, yo, that's Glup Shitter.
I was like, yo, that's Glup Shitter. That's fucking Low Backer from the Star Wars Holiday Special, and he's a Jedi now.
Wrong. Lumporu is Chewbacca-san from the Holiday Special. Lobaka is his Nifu fake fan.
Yeah, but no, those were all of my favorites as a kid. Fuck, speaking of Discworld, it's not a Discworld book, but Good Omens by Neil Gaiman and Pratchett.
We're just going to talk really about good. Pratchett for the rest of the hour, aren't we?
I wouldn't want to isolate Abby. But just phenomenal books. Really massive fan of them.